When I meet people, usually the first thing they are curious about is the teardrop that I have tattooed on my face. I believe this is evident of the innate wickedness that we all have, that we favor, and we are drawn to wicked things or what we might deem bad, evil, and wicked. This is what we would call innate wickedness or an innate idolatry, that we are drawn moreover to the things we make up, the images we have of the world, rather than the godly, good, beautiful, edifying, and pure things that God has truly brought forth. You know what, man? I've heard that before. I've had people tell me that, you know, they think that I must have done some really wicked things in my life that I've desired to be so into God or so compelled to preach the gospel. And, you know, more often than not, I tell them that, no, my worst sin is the same as yours. We all have this innate wickedness. You know, contrary to popular thought, we've all committed the worst sin, which is to act as though God does not exist. And that, you know, we are free to live according to our own desires, or that we would find life, that, you know, we're truly going to live YOLO, you know, you only live once, that we're truly going to find that life by living according to our own desires. That's the worst and most offensive sin that we see found throughout Scripture, and that needs to be highlighted. You see, in Wicked, what I do is I challenge you to get to know the biblical narrative. I challenge you with the wisdom of God, the knowledge of God, to seek it and hold fast to it. And then I guide you along a journey to identify and to remove wickedness in your life as well as within our world. You see, this is the goal, to become a resource that would help the ongoing battle of identifying wickedness, identifying strongholds, demolishing those strongholds, namely those that are set up by the carnal mind. Again, the Satan, the adversary, the very enemy of the people of God is that carnal mind. I help you identify this. I give you this wisdom and this knowledge and proof in Wicked, and I challenge you to study to show yourself approved, to search the Scriptures, to prove all things, so that we might present a true, healing, profitable, worthwhile, and wholesome gospel to a world that so desperately needs the healing that comes through Jesus Christ. While you can surely grab your copy of Wicked by visiting Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and ordering through any bookstore near you, the best advice I would give you in order for you to receive your signed copy of Wicked would be to visit www.wickedthingsexplained.wordpress.com. And for the next couple years, months, for as long as we can offer this resource, that website will also serve to further study, detail, and identify wickedness in our lives and in the world. I look forward to sending your copy when you order, again, at the website on the screen.